We're getting about to go to camp and book it.
It's good to be in fellowship. Especially around the word of God. Amen. So maybe while we are standing, we can open our Bibles. And to those who were not here yesterday, I bring you greetings from our church back home in Zimbabwe. And from several pastors and believers from around the country whom I notified we were coming here. They are sending their greetings to you. Amen. We just want to read from the book of John, chapter
4.
And we'll read from verse 21 up to verse 24. Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when you will neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have just read from your word, Lord, and we believe, Father God, that your word is life. May you, Father God, now bring that life into our hearts, O God. May you reveal your word and your will, Father God, that it may perfect us, Father God, that it may build in us, Lord, that which you called us to, Father. We commit, Father God, this portion of scripture into your hands, Lord, that you will enlighten it to our hearts, Father. And also we commit the speaker and the hearer, Lord God, that you may bring to us, Father, that which you purpose for us. We commit all this, Lord, into your hands for your glory. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, as you pray, amen. Amen. We may be seated. Now, we just want to speak on the word worship. Amen. Amen. You know, the Lord Jesus Christ told this woman that the hour is coming, and now is, when those who worship the Father must worship him in truth and in spirit. And now we all know that our God is the object of worship. And we are so mad that we desire to worship him. We are not like any other creatures, but in us there is that element that wants to worship God. There's a desire to worship God. But here the Lord now is saying, those who worship God must worship him in truth, because he is truth. They must worship him in spirit because he is spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So if God is truth, how shall we know the truthfulness of our hearts towards him who is true? Because it's not just a matter of worshipping, but it has to be in truth. Now, truth here is not just the opposite of false, but truth is the realization or the vindication
of
the manifestation of reality as compared to a shadow. Amen. So when we talk of truth, we are talking of a substance, something that can be held, something that is real, something that is matter, not just something that is imaginary, but that the reality of God. That's why the Bible says God is truth. Not just the opposite of a falsehood or a lie, but God is real. He is real in his being, and he must be worshipped in that reality. It must be the real you worshipping the real God. It cannot be something which is not you. It has to be you. Amen. And now, when it becomes you, it cannot be here, it's something which is just put on, and here something that is real. It has got to be totally you. And you being real, you being true, your mind, your heart, your soul, your everything must be you, and that you must be true. Amen. Not something that you just borrow from there or take from there, but we come to God as much as he is real, and we are also real. As much as he is true, we are also true. Amen. So how can we come to this position? How can we come into this condition? Because in this world, everything that is done is not the real thing. You know, actually we are living in this age we call the Laodicean church age. It is the last church age. According to the book of Revelation, this age, it thinks it's rich, yet it's poor. It thinks it can see, but it's blind. That's the age we are living in. There's a lot of put on. There's a lot of things that are just put to make something appear what it is really not. That's the age we are living in. Amen. We are living in an age where you can see from the how the world behaves, it's not a problem not to have hair. If you don't have hair, you can put on hair. You appear like you have long hair like this, but it's not real. It's not a problem to be dark complexioned.
Si vuto kala ofipa.
They've got the creams that they make.
Kuli mafuta wapanga.
Which can make you white.
Yakupanga mzungu.
So you cannot just stay black.
So that is a character they ofipa.
You'll be white.
But the color was white.
But that's not you.
Koma sindi wewe.
Can you see that? So as it is in the natural,
my manager need him to be.
So is it in the spiritual. There is no reality in the people of this age. That's why Jesus says, the hour is coming. But now that hour is now. Why was it now? Because Jesus Christ is the truth. Amen. How is he the truth? The Bible says, the law came by Moses. But grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. But did Moses come with a lie? For Jesus, he said he came with the truth. Was Moses a liar? No. He spoke the truth. But what Moses spoke was pointing to something that is real. And when Jesus came, he is the realization of the message of
Moses.
So when you worship, you worship now in that truth. The realization of the purpose of God. From the beginning of the world, God had a desire to be worshipped. And I want to believe he desired to be worshipped by you. That's why you are here. To worship God. Amen. And now when God is looking at you, he's just not going to see something that is false, something that is just made up, but he wants to see the reality of his mind. Amen. Because before you came, it was God's desire for what he really is to be portrayed. Amen. That's why when Jesus Christ, when he came, he did not just come to fulfill a mission, but he was the realization. He was the confirmation of the purpose of God. So much that when God looked on him, he said, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased to dwell in. He was the confirmation of the truth of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Now, since Jesus was that, he was accepted on those grounds. Not because he was doing good. Not because he was preaching. Not because he was worshipping. But he was the manifestation of the reality of God. Amen. You know, long back, I think in Italy, in this country, in Europe, in Italy, there was a man called Michelangelo. He was an artist. He could draw very beautiful art. And he could also, he was a sculptor. And one time, he had a picture in his mind of Moses. It was revealed to him in his mind. Because you know, these artists, you know, they are really inspired.
Awa ati awa makala na zelu zina zwa ikiwa mkati mwao.
So here, this picture of Moses in his mind.
Anali na ichitunzi cha Moses mkati mwaki.
So he took a marble stone.
Anatenga mwala uja wa salala.
And then he started to shape it.
Anambo useza.
Into the shape of Moses.
Mujitunzi cha Moses.
According to his mind.
Kulingana na zelu zake.
Anybody here?
Aliwanze pano.
Can draw a picture.
Anga jambule tofuno jambule.
And say this is Moses.
Ati ni Moses huyu.
Now when Michelangelo was making this picture of Moses.
Pamene Michelangelo analipanga chitunzi cha Moses.
He had the picture in his mind.
Anali nacho chitunzi mutu mwake.
And as he continued, I don't know how many years it took him.
Sitapema napitiliza vene chitamtenga zaka zingati.
But finally.
Koma mkusiriza.
He could see before him.
Analuona paliye.
The image of Moses.
Chitunzi tunzi cha Moses.
And that image of Moses.
Chitunzi tunzi cha Moses chijo.
It just was the perfect image that was in his mind.
Chinali chokwa na chitunzi tunzi chinali mtu mwake exactly.
So in his mind.
Mzelu mwake.
There was no image.
Munalipa chitunzi tunzi.
There was Moses.
Munali Moses.
He could see Moses in his mind.
Analuona Moses mtu mwake.
So when he looked at this image.
Pamena nao na chitunzi tunzi.
It so matched what was in his mind.
Chinagwiriza na chinali mtu mwake.
Until.
Mpaka.
He was not looking at an image.
Sana lulangana chitunzi tunzi.
He was looking at Moses.
Analulangana pali Moses.
Because that was in his mind.
Chiza chinali mtu mwake.
And then it said.
Chinati.
He took his chipping hammer.
Anatenga ijansimbi hama kanapenya sando.
This Moses on the knee.
Anamenya Mose apangokola.
And he tried to speak.
Akutiwe kamba.
Why?
Mchani.
Because to him.
Kwa hiye.
It was not an image.
Chinali chitunzi tunzi.
It was Moses.
Nali Mose.
So he wanted this Moses to speak.
Analufuna Mose kutalangule.
Although it was just an image.
Komachinali chitunzi tunzi cha.
Why?
Mchani.
Because it was the inspiration that was in him.
Chivuwa kunali uja mzeru zinali mkati mwake.
That, you know, portrayed this image.
Chinala angizira chitunzi tunzi cha.
Until the image was reality.
Mbaka chita chitunzi tunzi kwa hiyo chinakala tazoona.
That's the desire of God upon your life.
Ye kufuna kwa Mulungu pa moyo wako.
His desire in his heart.
Kufuna kwa Mulungu mtima
wake. For you to worship him.
Kutiwe umlambide.
When you come to that stage.
Ukabwela pa maonekedwe yaja.
It will please the heart of God.
Kisa kondweleza mtima wa Mulungu.
And say this is what I meant.
Ati chinde chinalu tanda uza.
When I said people should worship me.
Benina kamba kutiwa antu wanilambide.
Not something that looks like it.
Oza chimosi chipala nako nacho.
Not something that is taken from the world.
Chimosi chitenge watabe mziko la panzi.
But what is an inspiration from God himself. Until you are the reality of the purpose of God. Amen. And then you worship him. Amen. When you worship him, you'll be worshiping in truth. Because now, you are the realization of that truth. Amen. There's a lot of falsehood in this world. You know, people, they bring down God to something that they want him to be. But that's not it. God is God. He never changes. What he was from eternity, he will be to eternity. Amen. Amen. So we worship God in truth. Amen. What is truth? Truth is you. As you are, you don't have to change yourself. Come. Just as you are. Amen. You remember one time. There was a prostitute woman. She came where Jesus was. And Jesus was sitting with the people who worshipped God. And they were discussing or talking maybe about the things of God. But this woman. When she came. She did not just pretend to be one of them. She did not just appear as if she's also a Christian. She came as she was to the feet of Jesus Christ, and there she wept. The other people were rejoicing. They were singing. They were discussing scripture. They were eating that food. But she was not happy because she was a sinner. So when she came, she gave herself as she was. That's the truth. Amen. You don't have to pretend. Be what you are. That's what you are. When God is looking at you, He's not looking at something that is made up. He's looking at you. And He knows you. He knows your heart. He knows your life. He knows your everything. So don't pretend to be what you are not. Come as you are. Amen. If you are short, God knows you're short. Don't pretend to be tall. If you are tall, you are tall. Don't pretend to be short. Be what you are. God will accept you not on what you pretend to be, but what you are. Because that's what you are. And God has got everything for what you are. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. You remember Zacchaeus? He was short. So he thought of climbing a tree so that he may see Jesus. Jesus never said, you didn't climb high enough. Maybe on that other branch there, then you can see me better. He never said that. He says, come down. Be what you are. You are short. Just be short. Come down like you are.
Amen.
And what will I do? I will get away from all these people who are disturbing you to see me. I will go with you to your house. And I will eat with you at your house. Amen. Because that's what he was. Amen. So the Lord Jesus Christ is looking at you now as you are. Amen. Are you a sinner? That's why he died on the cross of Calvary. So that you can be forgiven your sin. Are you repentant? That's why he rose up. And he went back to heaven so that he can send the Holy Ghost upon you. Amen. Where is he now? He is at the throne of God. Amen. Where he presented his own blood. And that blood is there for you if you are a sinner. Amen. And that blood is the evidence that there was a life that was lived on earth. Amen. And because you repented and you give your life to God, the Holy Ghost will come down. Amen. And fill your heart. Why? Because you give your life to God. When you were a sinner, the blood covered your sin. It washed your sin. And the Spirit of God will come and dwell in you so that you can worship God. Amen. Everything is provided for by God. It is not you, but it is Him. Amen. So when we want to worship, why should we give ourselves problems of trying to be what we are not? Of pretending to be what we are not? Of straining ourselves? It's not good for you. Amen. Be what you are. God loves you. Not because you are good. Because you are what you are. He died for your sin. He rose up for your justification. He went up for your acceptance. And the Spirit came down for the confirmation. Amen.
Amen.
So he has done everything. He will do everything for you. Because he is good. Our God is good. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. You know, the problem with us is we want to be like something or somebody. Amen. That's our problem. There's a movie star. There's somebody who is a footballer. There's somebody who is a boxer. That's what we want to be. We want to be like him. You know, he is what he is. Because that's what he is. And you are not that. Why don't you want you to be who you are? Amen. And dress like who you are. And be like who you are. And eat like who you are. And then you come to God like who you are.
Amen.
And he'll accept you as who you are. Amen. There's no hassle. Amen. God is good. Amen. So how can we become true? It's by coming to him. He who is true. Amen. As long as we come to him with an open heart. You remember Zacchaeus? I said he was told to come down. And the Lord says, I'll go with you to your house. When they were at the house, Jesus never preached any sermon. He never said, now you Zacchaeus, I can see your heart. I see there's this. I know your life. You have done this. You have done that. He never did that. He just sat with him. Amen. If you happen to sit with him, you'll be different. Amen. Amen. When they sit together, amen, eating, Zacchaeus said, Lord, from whomever I've stolen, I'm going to replace what I stole fourfold. I'm going to take half of my riches and give to the poor. Amen. What was he saying? He was saying something from his heart. Because he was now in the presence of truth. If you happen to come into the presence of truth, you know, because the problem is, the people come and want to worship. But it even starts with the preacher. He is not even real. He wants to pattern himself after somebody. He wants to be what he is not. Yes, there is the gift of tongues from the Holy Ghost. But he himself, he starts to give himself tongues. There's no truthfulness. And everybody wants to be like that. And at the end of the day, you are getting a lot of falsehood. Amen.
Amen.
You see, there'll be something, this fire. People are falling down. They are not real. It's not real. And at the end of the day, people go out. They live in sin. They dress sinfully. They speak sinfully. Because there's no reality. Amen. But why not come in the simplicity of who you are? Amen. And just come to God. I have come. Amen. Because God knows you. Amen. He doesn't accept you because you are speaking in tongues. He doesn't accept you because you are jumping up and down. He doesn't accept you because I'm preaching. No.
Yeah.
He doesn't even accept me because I'm preaching here. God accepts the truth. Amen. And you must be true. Don't put on anything. Amen. Don't make yourself what you are not. But be that simple.
Kala sabozi chepesa.
And be what you are.
Kala mwamene ulili.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yalizike zina la Mungu.
So that is the aspect of being true.
Iyo ndiye maonekedi okala chonadi.
Be what you are.
Kala mwamene ulili.
Be true.
Kala chonadi.
Amen. Because God has got a remedy for anything. Amen. Whatever your problem is, Zacchaeus was a thief. That woman was a prostitute. Mary of Magdala was a prostitute with seven evil spirits. All these people, they came to Jesus. And they were made whole. Amen. If he did that, can he not do it to me? Can he not do it to you? Amen. Because at the end of the day, we want to worship God. Amen. You know, sometimes, you know, there are two different things, you know. We pray to God, asking for things, but we also worship God. Amen. So there's a difference between prayer and worship. Amen. At the end of the day, we want to be true worshippers. Because here Jesus says, those who want to worship God, they must worship Him in truth and in spirit. Amen. Now, but those who want to pray, yes, they can come and pray. You see, everybody prays. You are in problems, you pray. You are hungry, you pray. You are sick, you pray. But that is different from worshipping. Amen. So we want to be worshippers. We want to worship God. And what does it take to worship? It takes the truth. And it also takes the spirit. In the second book of Corinthians, or first book of Corinthians, chapter 2, First Corinthians chapter 2,
verse 10.
But God has revealed them to us through His Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God.
Tosalako mzimu wa muntu wamene uli mwa iye. Chimozi mozi. Vintu kulipe muntu wamene aziwa vintu vya Mulungu koma mzimu wa Mulungu.
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God.
So pano ise talandira vintu osati vya mdziko la pansi. Koma vintu vya mumzimu amene uli wa Mulungu kuti tingaziwe vintu vamene vopasiwa kwa ife mahala kuchoka kwa Mulungu.
Amen. Now, we want to worship God.
Tifuna lambira Mulungu.
In truth.
Mchonadi.
Amen. And in spirit.
Na mumzimu.
Amen. Amen. As I was trying to tell you,
mameni nalifuna kuzirani.
When we talk of the spirit,
mukalamba kwabali mzimu.
You know, back home in our country, you know, we have got these people who say they worship in spirit. And now when somebody is in the spirit, he may start shaking his head. So when they do that, they are now in the spirit. That's what the Spirit is to them. Amen. Now, I think you are very much privileged here in Zambia. You have got a television program that just brings out Christian things. I think you know what happens on those things. When the Spirit comes. Amen. Somebody can just take his handkerchief.
Everybody's
in the spirit.
They
can do anything in the spirit. But let's be sincere with ourselves. The Bible here says we must worship him in spirit. What is spirit? Is it something that is man-made? Is it something that is manufactured by man? The spirit must be the spirit. Amen. And here the Bible says, how does man know things of man? How do you know the things of man? You take a small boy of 2 years and a small girl of 2 years. Do you have to teach them? Now you see, you are a boy. I'm telling you, my son, you must never play with a doll. Because dolls are for girls. Don't play with the dolls. You must take a little thing like a motor car, and then you play with it. Now you daughter. Chonde.
Mazona.
Don't start climbing trees like that. You are a girl. Here is a doll.
Kakadoli kakwa.
Play with this.
Uzisowele na kadoli.
Is that what you do to your children?
Yewe mmashitila wana wanu.
You don't have to tell them.
Osa wauza.
There's a spirit in them.
Muli mzimu mkati mwao.
He is a man.
Ni mamuna.
He thinks like a man.
Aganza muna mamuna.
He has got feelings of a man.
Aina kuganza wa mamuna.
Even me we're here.
Na ine pano.
I start walking.
Ngamboenda.
I don't have to be careful.
Sini kakonze.
Maybe I can walk like a woman, eh? Let me be careful. Let me just walk like a man. Eh? I don't have to do that. I'm a man. I don't have to speak like a man. I must be careful. You see, I may speak like a woman. My voice is a man. Because I'm a man. With the spirit of a man. The genes of a man. Amen. That's who I am. Amen. So here the Bible is telling us, who will know a man except the spirit of a man that is in that man? I can take a woman from Zimbabwe, bring her to
Zambia,
and just let her mix with the other women. They get along very fine. Why? They've got the spirit of a woman. Amen. It's easy for them. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. And now when you see a man acting like a woman, it's a perversion. It's a perversion. If you see a woman, why should walk like a man? It's a perversion. You see a woman? Why to dress like a man? It's a perversion. You see a man? Trying to be all smart. Careful with the hair. Take this cream, put here. Take some perfume there. Why should you wear pink shoes? It's a perversion. If you are a man, be a man. You know Job one time? He was sick. He had boils all over the body. He was feeling pain. And then God came. He said, Job, stand up like a man. Tie your waist.
Manga belt
like a man.
Manga mamuna.
I want to speak to you. Amen. He wanted to speak to Job like a man. Because Job was a man. If you are a man, God wants to speak to you as a man. Because that's what you are. If you are a woman, He speaks to you as a woman. Because that's what you are. Amen. Amen. So be what you are. Because it's the spirit of a man that is in a man that makes him to behave the way he behaves. And I know things of a man by the spirit of a man that is in me. And here the Bible says, for you to know the things of God, you must have the spirit of God. Amen.
Amen.
If the spirit of God comes in you, then you will know the things of God. Not just by being taught, but by inspiration. As I was saying, it doesn't mean the mothers don't teach their girls how to behave. Yes, they tell them, you should do this. Do that. Yes. And the girl will accept those things because of the spirit of a girl that is in
her.
You get the point. So, here the Bible says, the spirit of God reveals to us the things of God. We were not given the spirit of the world. The spirit of the world has got the things of the world. They've got the musicians of the world. They've got the, you know, the playboys of the world. They've got the actresses of the world. You were not given that spirit. If you have that spirit, you want to be that actress. You want to be like that actor. You want to be like this one. Because you've got that spirit. But you were not given that spirit. You were given the spirit of God. Amen. And that spirit of God is holy. Amen. That spirit of God is a spirit of worship. That spirit of God is a spirit of reality. That spirit of God is a spirit of truth. That's what we were given so that we can worship God. Amen. Amen. We don't receive the spirit of the world. Amen. The spirit of the world is filthy. Amen. It will lead us to filthy things. Amen. You listen to the songs they sing. They promote sin. Look the way they dance. It promotes sin. Look the way they dress. It promotes sin. That's the spirit of the world. You did not receive that spirit. You received the spirit from above. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Why did God have to give you the spirit? So that you can worship. Amen. Praise be to God. Now, we come now to the word worship. Amen. Now, worship is a reverence to God. Amen. Not in word only, but in deed. Amen. This is when God has made known to you His ways. Amen. He has revealed to you His will. He has revealed to you His purpose. Amen. Because when God wanted a man to be a man, you know, He created him in a way that will make him think like a man, walk like a man, talk or speak like a man. It's all designed in him. Amen. So that at the end of the day, as soon as you start walking, you walk like a man. When you start speaking, you speak like a man. There is an abiding spirit. You have hormones of a man. Amen. So when God wants to be worshipped, He doesn't want you to worship on Sunday. And on Monday or something else. Worship is to give reverence to God. Even here in church. And when you go out, you give that reverence to God. In the way you live, the way you dress, the way you behave, you are worshiping God. Amen. That's why God made a woman. Gave her the mind of a woman. Gave her the hormones of a woman. When she starts to walk, she's just a woman. Amen. Because of what is in her. She's not a woman on Monday. And on Tuesday she's a man. On Wednesday she's another thing. That's not it. Amen. So worshiping God is not a Sunday business. It's something that is in you. It's your life. It's your thinking. It's your imagination. It's your desires. It's your everything. You worship God. You give reverence to God. Amen. When you give reverence to God, then you present your body as a living sacrifice that is acceptable before God. Amen. You remember in the Old Testament when they had to bring a sacrifice, they had to bring here a sheep, a lamb. Amen. They did not make it Nkosa that moment. It's already Nkosa. Born Nkosa. Grew up Nkosa. You get the point? When it's brought there, it's life, it's being, it's sharp, it's feelings, it's just a sheep. Amen. And when you take it, you cut it, it doesn't complain. Because it's a sheep. It's made for sacrifice. Amen. That's who you are. Amen. You are a worshiper of God. Amen. Because God has shown you. God has revealed to you by His Spirit who He is. Amen. And if it's revealed to you, blessed be the name of the Lord. When it's revealed to you, you know, it will just get all those rubbish things out of you. Amen. Because now you are worshiping. Amen. Remember, it's not just you are praying. It's you are worshiping. Amen. You live the life of worship. Amen. How does it happen? When God has revealed to you His mind, His purpose, His desire, His truth, when it's revealed to you, amen, by His Spirit, and it comes into you, it will transform you into that being that can worship God. Amen. In the book of Psalms, chapter
25.
Psalms 25. We read verse 4. Show me your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. On you I wait all the day.
Zilangizeni njira yanu ambuye. Unziseni njira yanu. Nisokoleleni mchona dichanu. Unziseni. Bakuti mandime mulungu wachipulu muso changa.
Thank you.
Baimwe nizakala waembekeza zuvalonse.
Amen. Show me your ways. David is desiring from God.
David alagalaga kutoka kwa Mulungu.
Show me your ways.
Nilangizeni njira
zani. The problem with us.
Manje vuto yatu.
We want to make ways.
Tifuna banga njira
zani. We want to make our own way.
Tifuna banga njira zani.
Of praying.
Zobembe.
If you tell somebody.
Ukauza mtu.
What, you know, the Bible.
Bible.
Says we must be baptized.
Tifani kwa badi zika.
He says I'm already baptized. Okay, that's fine. If you are baptized, you have done just exactly what God wants you to do. Because you are now baptized. By the way, when were you baptized? You know, when I was 2 months old, my mother took me to the priest and he baptized
me.
You see? He feels he is baptized. But the Bible,
manje Bible,
it tells us the way to be baptized.
It was anjira mo batizikira.
Amen. It says you must repent of your sins.
Ya machimo yako.
You know, the word has got to be preached.
Mawe yafani kolalikiwa.
And you hear.
Uzamvera.
You accept the word.
Uzavomekeza mawe.
And you repent.
Uzalapa.
Amen. You know, I've been preaching for more than 30 years. But I've never met a preacher. Neither have I ever done it myself. To preach to a 2 month old baby. And it repents. I still have to meet that preacher. He is the best preacher ever. Who can make a 2 month old baby to repent? Why? Because people have made their own ways of worship. David is saying, show me your ways. It's not us making ways, but it is God to show us his ways. How we should be baptized. The Bible tells us it is God's way. We must repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Anyone who was baptized in the Bible, it was in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That is God's way. Show me your ways. That's what David is asking God. Amen. Before I start to do anything, show me your ways. Teach me how I should go. Amen. I don't have to teach God. Some people will say, that is old fashioned. People were worshipping like that because it's old fashioned. They want to teach God the new fashion. Because they think God is still old fashioned. So they want to put him in the new fashion. David says, teach me your ways. Amen. So that I may know. Amen. And when I know your ways. Amen. Here it says. Lead me in your truth. For you are the God of my salvation. On you I will wait all day. Amen. Amen. We want to worship God. David says, now I'll wait upon you.
David,
not just for a minute. Not just for an hour. But all day. Amen. I'll totally give myself to you. If you teach me your ways. Amen. So true worship comes after God has revealed his way. After God has shown you His word, after God has shown you His precepts, that's when you start to worship God. And then you will be a worshiper in truth and in spirit. You don't have the spirit of the world, you have the spirit of God. Amen. You don't have the way of the world, you are in the way of the Lord. You are not in the way of the denominations, you are in the way of the revealed word. That's when now you start to worship God. The problem is people, they just want to come and worship and they think God is satisfied. Well, I come on a Sunday, I'll just sing songs, I'll worship, praise Him. Do that, after that, I go, I live the way I want to live, and come back next Sunday. That's not what we are being called to. We are being called to worship God. Amen. Doesn't the Bible say, you are the temple of the living God? The temple is not just something temporal. The temple is there. The temple was built of stone. It stayed there. So that the presence of God will stay there. Amen. And what was it? It was to prove the presence of God. So you are the temple now. Amen. The temple, when Jesus came, he saw them selling bird, doves in there and exchanging money in there. He drove them all out. He said, this is my Father's house. It's meant for prayer, not for selling things. You get the point? So you are the temple of God, designed for prayer, to worship God. Amen. It's not today is worship, tomorrow the nyumba ya malonda,
tomorrow is the house of business.
No, you are the house of God. Amen. The Spirit of God dwells in you, so that you can be the object of God will be the object of worship in you. Amen. That's why David says, show me your ways, reveal to me your purpose, show me your desire, so that I can worship God. Amen. When I'm walking on the street, I'll be worshiping God. When I'm sitting in my house, I'll be worshiping God. Yes, I'm the temple of God. And the Spirit of God dwells in me. Amen. It influences my thinking. It influences my feelings. It influences how I walk. I am a worshiper of God. The hour is coming, and now is, when true worshippers will have to worship God in truth and in spirit. Amen. And you take the Spirit of God. Amen. You know what God does? He reveals to you, He shows you His greatness, He shows you His beauty, He shows you His love. You know, after all that is revealed to you, you can do nothing but just worship God. Amen. You are not forced to worship. But what God has done in your life will make you to be a worshiper. Amen. There's nothing else you can do but to worship God. Amen. You cannot move again in the sinful ways of the world, because God has done something to you. Amen. We just look at a few examples of people who God did something in their life and they started to worship God. Amen. Let's just go to the book of Genesis chapter 24.
Genesis 24.
Verse 7.
Numbers 7.
The Lord God of heaven, who took me from my father's house and from the land of my family, and who spoke to me and swore to me, saying, to your descendants I give this land, he will send his angel before you, and you shall take a wife for my son from there.
Ambuye mulungu wakumwamba amena na njenga kutoka mnyumba ya tete wanga ndipo sa kutoka kumalo kwa banja langa ndipo sa ananiuza inekuti anati lapira kwa ine ukambe iwe suza katenga anati kwa ine iwe nizapata ayamalo kumbeu yako ndiponso nizatuma mgeri wanga kukusogolera ndiponso zakatenga mkazi kumwana wanga kutoka kuli ya jamalo.
Thank you. Now here, Abraham is telling his servant,
Abraham auza kapolo wake,
go to that land
enda kumalo kuja,
and bring a wife for my son.
Unwezele mkazi wa mwana wanga.
And then the servant says, how will I know to choose the wife? Well, if I find her and I ask her to come and she refuses, shall I take your son to that country for the wife? Abraham said, don't you do that. Because the God who took me out of the land of my people and brought me here and told me he's going to give this land to my descendants, that same God will send an angel before you who will lead you to bring a wife for my son. Amen. So the angel was going to lead this servant. Amen. What was he going to do? He was going to find a wife for his master's son. Amen. So it needed this angel to lead him. Amen. Why did God have to send an angel? Why did God have to do all these things? Because whatever God does to you as an individual, the end result is that he wants you to worship. Amen. We cannot just do things. That's why at the end of the world, he's going to judge this world. Amen. He's sending rain. He's giving us oxygen. Do you know how much it costs for you to breathe? You have to be sick one time. And then they have got to take you to the oxygen tank. When you can't breathe on your own, that's how much you, that's when you see how much it costs. Amen. Do you know how much it costs for you to have blood? Where do we get our blood? We eat banana.
Zima.
Vegetables. That's where we get blood. Is it that cheap? Go to the hospital one time and they tell you need a blood transfusion to give you blood. You'll see how much it costs. These things, all these things God has given us, just free. What does he desire? For us to worship him. Amen. That's why he's going to judge this world. Amen. For not worshiping him. So he's going to send his angel before this servant of
Abraham
so that he will lead him to bring a wife for his son. Let's go to verse 10. Then the servant took 10 of his master's camels and departed, for all his master's goods were in his hand. And he arose and went to Mesopotamia, to the city of Nao.
Ujawa kapola anatenga makamera yali teni ya mbu yake ndipo sana nyamuka na katundu onse wa mbu yake anapita ananyika manjo mwake ndipo sana ananyamuka anapita kumalo kwa Mesopotamia kumzinda wana hall.
And he made the camels to kneel outside the city by a well of water at even time, the time when women go out to draw water.
Ndipo sana lengisa makamera yake kugwada panja pamzinda pafupi na chisime pamena azimai anapita mazulo kutunga mazi.
Then he said, O Lord God of my master Abraham, please give me success this day and show kindness to my masters, to my master Abraham.
Anatambuye mlungu ambuye wanga Abraham nipe mpakwa imwe kutirelo mpere chifundo kuti mlangiza chifundo kula ambuye wanga Abraham.
Behold, here I stand by the well of water, and the daughters of the men of the city are coming out to draw water. Now let it be that the young woman to whom I said, please lay down your pitcher that I may drink, and she says, drink, and I will also give your camels a drink. Let her be this, the one you have appointed for your servant Isaac, and by this I will know that you have shown kindness to my master.
Lekani uyu msikana kale wamene muzasanga kukala mkazi wa mtumiki wanu Isaki. Ndiponso nizaziwa kuti mwanangiza chifundo kula mbuye wanga anantuma.
And it happened before he had finished speaking that behold, Rebekah, who was born to Bethuel, the son of Milcah, the wife of Nahor, Abraham's brother, came out with her pitcher on her shoulder.
And zinachitika pamene apa kuti anasiriza kamba uyu munthu. Nsika na Rebekah anatoka mwana wa Batuele, mwana wa Mika. Wamikaele mkazi wana home bale wa Abraham anabwera na mgomo wake pamapewa.
And now the young woman was very beautiful to behold, a virgin, no man had known her, and she went down to the well, filled her pitcher and came out.
Ndiposo msikana anarokongola anali mnamwali sana dziwe mamuna liwonse ndiposo anapita kuchitsime na tapa madzi yake anabwera.
And the servant ran to her and said, please let me drink a little water from thy pitcher.
Ndipotso uja wanchito anatamanga anampempha kuti nipemphapo mpatseko manzi akumwa mgomo wako.
Amen. Now maybe we'll just read that far. Here is now that servant. Abraham said, the angel of God will lead you. Now, after he had reached the city, he offered a prayer to God. He says, let the woman whom I'll say give me some water, that you also give water to the camels. And when he had prayed the prayer, he says, Rebekah came. And he said, can you give me water? And Rebekah gave him the water. And she said, I'll also water the camels. Amen.
Amen.
Because he had prayed, and now the answer is answered. The prayer is answered. Amen. Now, when God had answered the prayer, then he was sure this was the girl who was supposed to be Isaac's wife. Amen. Now, so this girl gave now the water to the camels. I just want to show you another verse. Verse 20. And she quickly emptied the pitcher into the trough, ran back to the well to draw water, and drew for all his camels.
Mamsanga anatamanga anasiriza mazi mgomo mwake ndipo sana pitiriza anachira maro mwina And the
men wondering at her remained silent as to know whether the Lord had made his journey prosperous or not.
Jamamuna anakala chete kudabwa kwambo ganiza kuti kodi ulendo wanga Mulungu wanianga olobwani.
Amen. When Rebecca did exactly how he had prayed, now this man was now going back to God and then recognizing this really is God who has led me. Because Abraham had said, the angel will lead you. Amen. Now the angel was supposed to lead him to find the wife. Now, according to the Bible, if God brings you to himself,
he
will have to make you clean. He has to bring out all the filthy things out of your life. There's a way that God deals with somebody who has come to him.
Now,
when you see that happening in your life, then you can recognize the Spirit of God dealing with you. Amen. The Spirit of God will not deal with you and let you walk in the filthy ways of this world. Amen. Amen. The angel was, it was said, the angel will lead you. So this servant is now proving that really the angel is leading me. He puts a prayer to God, and exactly as he has asked, God brings this girl and she starts to do exactly what he asked. Then he can feel it. Then he can see it. That this must be God. Amen. There are many things which are not of God. When you look the way they do the things, the way they want to worship, the way they want to present the word of God, you can see this is not God.
Amen.
Amen. But when you come really to God, God will deal with your life. You don't need any laws. You don't need any commandments. All you need is to know the way of the Lord. When God reveals it in you and gives you the Spirit to reveal himself, you will feel it. You will know it. You will accept it. It will do things in your life. Amen. It will clean you up. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. There was one man, a prophet of God. He was preaching down there in South Africa. And those, you know how the Zulus wear their dresses? You know, they just wear very short dresses. A naked top is nothing to them. And while the word of God was being preached, when the prophet of God was preaching the word of God, and the Spirit of God came down and filled the place, you know what happened? Those women, they just took showers and covered themselves. Something told them, you are naked. Amen. That's what the Spirit of God does to you when it comes into your life. It will show you the right way to go. It will show you the bad things that are in you so that you can live the life of filthiness to walk in the way of righteousness. So this servant, when he saw that happening, he saw that God was truly leading him. Amen. It was God, not man. You will feel it. It's God, not a church. It's God, not a man. God has met your life. God has come into your life. God is changing your mentality. God is changing the way you look at things. He is coming into your life. He is showing you the way. Amen. You will feel it. You will know it. Amen. Because it is God. So this man was now looking. He wanted to prove. Is really the angel leading me? And when he saw that, Rebecca was doing exactly that. Amen. Maybe to save time, I'll just read maybe one or two scriptures. Amen. So this man asked this woman, this girl, whose daughter are you? Where are you coming from? And then the girl told him that he was, she was the daughter of Bethel. Amen. Who was a relative of Abraham. And then the man started to, you know, to rejoice inside him. Really, the Lord is leading me. Amen. Verse 25. Moreover, she said to him, we have straw and feed enough and room to lodge.
Inde pamwamba pake anapitiriza nati tinde tirinazo mauzu yakuti zingadi ya nyama zako na zakudya zokupasa na malo yogona tirinayo.
Then the man bowed down his head and worshipped the Lord.
Ujamamuna anakonta mamutu na alambira mbuye.
Amen. When he saw how God had led him, how God had selected this woman, how God had answered his prayer, it was not him, but it was God dealing with his life, doing whatever was supposed to be done. The Bible here said he bowed his head and he worshipped God. Remember, he prayed to God. Now he is not praying. He is now worshipping. Amen. After the way of the Lord had been revealed to her, to him, after the glory of God had been shown him, he started to worship. When God reveals himself to you, when God does those good things in your life, you'll start to worship him. Amen. You'll worship God with your life, with your being, with your everything, because it is God who has revealed himself to you. That's when true worship begins. And the hour is coming, and now is, when true worshipers, they must be true. How can you be true if you have not seen the truth? How can you be true if you have not come the way of the truth? How can you be true yet you are not baptized in the true way? You have not repented in the true way. True worshippers will worship in truth because they heard the truth. It was revealed to them. God has shown them his way. If God shows you like it was here, you will worship God. Amen. And you worship him in truth. Because he has shown you the truth. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Maybe we can just go to verse 50.
Give me 15.
50.
Oh, give me 50.
So they sent away Rebecca, their sister. I was reading 59. 9 and 0, it looks like the same. My eyes are dim. Okay. Then Laban said, and then Laban and Bethuel answered and said, the thing comes from the Lord. We cannot speak to you either bad or good. Here is Rebecca before you. Take her and go, and let her be your master's son's wife, as the Lord has spoken. And it came to pass, when Abraham's servant heard their words, that he worshipped the Lord, bowing himself to the earth.
Labani na Betuwele wanayanka wanati, ichi chintu chitokera kwa mbuye, ndiponso ife, stinga kambe kwa iwe chabu ino choipa, koma uyu wamuona na beka lipa iwe, mtenge pitanaya kakale mkazi wa mwana wa mbuye wako, kulingana mamena mbuye ya kuzira iwe. Ndiponso, wanchito uja anabweresa, zintu zabu ino zodula, mbaso za siriva na za golide na zovara anapereka kwa rabeka ndiposo na kumbare waki.
Thank you. Can you read verse 52?
Oh. Ndiposo zinajitika kutipa mene uja wanchito Abraham anamvera ya mau analambira mbuye gada pansi padoti.
Amen. Abraham's servant,
wanchito Abraham,
when he had spoken what he has spoken, the parents of Rebecca,
Makolo wa Rebecca,
says you can take her,
ngamtenge.
And also they had to ask her if she would want to go. She says, sure, I will go. He had come to find a wife, and the angel was said he would lead him.
Mungera nata za msogolera.
And the angel led him.
Mungera na msogolera.
He came to the well.
Anabwera kumalwe.
He prayed.
Anapembera.
And God did exactly how he prayed.
Mulungu anachita vokwana mwena anapemperera.
And then he asked Rebecca.
Anapemba Rebecca.
Rebecca accepted it.
Anavomera Rebecca.
He asked the parents.
Anapemba Makolo.
The parents accepted it.
Makolo anavomera.
Just as Abraham had told him.
Mwamena Abraham anamagulira.
That the angel will lead you.
Kuti mungera za kusogolera.
Now after all this had been revealed to him, what could he do but to worship God? Amen. There's nothing you can do after God has revealed himself to you. After God has revealed his word to you, there is something in you that will make you to worship God. Amen. You'll worship him and give your life to him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. When grace is shown to you, it will cause you to worship God. If you look at your life, what you have been, what the devil made you to do, what the evil spirits made you to do, and God, by his grace, reveals to you his will and deliver you from the pangs of the devil, from the prison of the evil spirits, you will start to worship God. Amen. Israel was in bondage.
Israel,
if you read in chapter 4 of Exodus, they were in bondage. And Moses was sent to bring them out. Moses went to Egypt and he called all the elders and he revealed to them the will and the purpose of God. He says, God has sent me to tell you this, that he wants to bring you out. And all the elders, before anything was done, when it was revealed to them the purpose and the desire of God, if you read in Exodus chapter 4, it will tell you they worshipped God. Amen. You cannot worship him until his truth is revealed to you. You will worship him if the truth is revealed to you. When God's way has been proved to you, when the grace of God is shown you, that it is the desire of God to bring you out of the prison of the devil, it will make you worship God. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Why? Because God has done it to you.